So, welcome. Everybody, for whatever reason, oh, hang on. What did I do? Where did I put it? I'm not ready. Hang on.
God damn it, Patty.
Okay, yeah. So, for whatever reason, you guys felt the call of the call to aid. You felt the call. Basically, it's just, you guys have all seen this, right?
Mm-hmm.
A little notice that says, slay the great woodpecker. There's a village called Goldfield, and they have a terrible woodpecker that keeps everybody awake at all hours, and it's echoes, the echoing taps of its beak can be heard throughout the land, and everybody's very upset with it. So you all make your way to Goldfield Village, which is down here. Can you guys see that?
Yeah.
Cool.
Yep.
That's working. And when you arrive, boom. Everybody goes to Goldfield. So now, before the adventure starts, is there anything that anybody would like to do while they when they arrive in town?
So, have we met each other at this point, or
not
are we
yet.
Going separately?
Not yet. Okay. Yeah.
Not yet. This is like before you even roll into town. Is there anything that anybody has to do?
Can I stop in the bakery and get a fresh pastry?
Sure. Yeah. So on your way into town, you swing by the bakery, and there's a bartender there, and a dwarvish bartender, his name is Bowlegs, and let me pull up Bowlegs. Bam. He has some stuff from the bakery to sell you. The baker's not there at the time, but you know he has a few things, a few rolls and stuff. They cost a few copper.
I'll take the freshest one, please.
Okay. Oh, here you go. Here's a nice fresh roll. It was made yesterday.
Okay, that's close enough. Thank you.
Okay. And he sees that you're holding one of the notice papers, and he points you off in the direction of the meeting hall, which is over here.
So, all right.
Anybody else?
I think I get a lay of the town, but then I go directly to the meeting hall. I don't look at anything else.
Okay. So, you're all present in the meeting hall, and a dim firelight dances on the walls of the modest meeting hall. The iron bars of the central fire pit cast vertical shadows on the strangers gathered around you. Through the windows, you can just make out the setting sun. Out of the other window, the two moons. One is eclipsed, and the other one is small and glittering. Oh, Draga's still eclipsed, says the constable. He tosses another log on the fire, which erupts in a cacophony of resinous pops and hisses. And around you are the whole party. So this is your moment to introduce yourselves and do what you gotta do.
Real quick. Laura, can you hear us?
I can hear Cassie.
But why are you hearing me? I haven't been talking.
Okay.
Technology.
But if anyone else has said anything, then I can't hear it. Besides Metroid.
I can't hear myself, so.
You're not supposed to hear. Okay.
Metroid,
maybe she's
Katie
refreshing her browser.
Or Luke have been talking, then I haven't.
It used to like tell you like if they were connected by a mic.
Yeah, the mic icon is gone.
Huh.
I don't know what happened. Okay. Well, we can all hear each other. Everybody say yes.
Yes.
Yeah, yes. I can hear y'all.
Okay. Hey, yeah, I think we did.
Cassie, say yes.
Yes.
Yeah. We all heard each other. Okay. Anyway, so you guys are all in the meeting hall. So, who's going to be the first to introduce themselves?
I guess I can start. When I walked in the meeting hall, you see just a hulking, gray-skinned half-orc, and you can just very weathered skin. When I turn to the side, it's just very dirty, giant dreads coming off the back, you know, under a bandana, and you know how they put like little trinkets in their dreads sometimes. There's a little bit of that going on. But the thing that's kind of odd is he's wearing this very shiny, bright, like brand spanking new set of chainmail. And if you've ever seen a teenager wear a suit to an interview for the first time and how it looks like they don't fit in it at all, this is sort of what he looks like. And you can tell he's really trying to pull it off, but like it just looks very out of place on him, and he kind of, you know, thuds onto his seat and surveys the room.
Okay. Do you interact with anybody in the room, or?
No, I'm waiting for someone to make the first move.
Okay, Katie, why don't you go next?
So I walk in. We're going to the tavern, is that what you said?
It's the meeting hall.
Meeting hall? Okay, sorry.
It's like so Skyrim, big long hall, kind of pine wood building.
Okay, so I walk in, and I'm very marveled at the inner building area. I'm eating my pastry. Just a normal height and weight, average-looking kind of human, with red hair and a big smile on her face, and you know, clothes that are easy to move around in. And the one thing you do notice is that she's got like one of those drums that go around, like small little drums that go around her neck, and it comes down and it's like on her side, so it's kind of she's got it around her side, so you notice that. She's just smiling and looking at the room, kind of ooing and on.
Okay, who's next? Laura?
Oh, okay. I walk into the meeting hall very, like, calmly, yet I feel like all the time that I'm owning the place, like, you just feel this wave of power as I step in, just commanding the room, and then I just sit quietly in the back of the corner and say nothing.
And what's your character look like?
She's not too tall, but not too short, like medium height. And her hair is very long, like it's almost to like the back of her knees, and it's in these long braids. And she's dark skin, and she has horns coming out of her head. She's a tiefling, obviously. Like she's obviously like a tiefling. And she's wearing a mixture of gold and purple robes, and she has this very sort of spiritual look about her, like she's from some sort of church or temple.
Okay. And lastly, Cassie.
So, when she walks in, she's relatively unassuming. Like, she's wearing green with old brown leather armor that clearly has seen some use. All her weapons are pretty much visible. You can see daggers on her legs and on her face, framed by dark hair that's emphasizing her pointed ears. Is on her face is a sneer that she keeps throughout the entire walk in as she takes occasional swigs from a flask.
Okay. So I'm just going to have a moment here. Let's say, like, 2 minutes to for everybody to, if they want to, interact with each other or otherwise.
Would it be obvious, like, are we the only ones in this room?
Yeah, it's just you guys and the constable, who's just kind of tending to the fire.
Oh, okay. So, y'all saw the paper, right?
Yes. Okay. Looks promising.
I know! I'm very excited for this this little adventure.
I mean, if the money's good, the money's good, I suppose. Hopefully we get paid by the end of this.
Did I catch any of y'all's names?
Oh, sorry, I didn't introduce myself. I should do that. My name is Eleanor Higginbotham. I don't want to get too much into myself. I like to talk about myself a lot. I'm sorry. I'm just really excited. Who are y'all?
Name's Bilge.
Bilge?
Aye. Bilge.
Since I asked, I'm Esvel.
Temerity, but those who know me call me Tem. So you may call me Tem, since we are possibly doing something dangerous.
Okay. Well, wow, it's so nice to, like, to meet people and get out there, and, do y'all know what time's supposed to start at?
The constable just kind of, like, tends to the fire. Her lady will be here soon. Any second now. And then almost, as soon as the last word leaves his lips, a woman burst into the room. She's tall, bespectacled. She's a tall, bespectacled tiefling. Why did I write that? Bespectacled? She's got glasses.
She's wearing glasses.
Yeah. She's tall, she has glasses. She has reddish skin. And she feigns an attempt to hide her impatience and then just gives up. Thank you all for coming. I am Lady Sebastian. She curtsies briefly. And if you don't mind, I'd like to get straight to business. You all got the letter?
Aye.
Yeah.
Excellent. Okay. You know, she, like, dusts herself off. She's wearing a very, like, very elegant gown. Not something you would normally see in, like, a farming village. She moves over to the constable, kind of shoos him out of the room. Okay. So here's the rub. There's a woodpecker in our forest, and it's disrupting our logging community, or our farming community, and our logger. The farmers of nearby farm have actually been pushed out of their home because of all the monsters that have been pushed out of the forest. We've had reports of people staying up all night because of the loud rapping on the trees, and personally, I hate the thing, and I'd rather not be here, so I'd like to have someone else get rid of it so that my father can stop pestering me. And I'm not even supposed to be here, I'll put it that way. So, get rid of the woodpecker and you get paid. Simple as that.
That sounds like fun!
Do we
know
anything about this woodpecker?
Which one's causing it?
It's big, you can't miss it, and, well, it's the great woodpecker. I don't know what else, I don't know much more than that. And you'll have to speak to the farmer Lem. He's in the tavern.
Generally, big means dangerous.
Oh, it's very dangerous. Otherwise, we would have had this dealt with years ago. Or, I mean, weeks ago. Not years.
Well, okay. You said the farmer knows where it's at?
Yes, he's currently residing in the inn. He's been ejected from his home.
Because of the woodpecker.
And the monsters.
Oh, lovely.
Monsters?
Well, there are some common beasts in the forest, but they seem to have taken residence in his farm. They're mostly harmless, but he'd rather not stay there. To be frank, I think he's just scared for his children.
Can't have that now, can we?
What was that?
Can't have that now, can we?
Oh, yes, right.
Either it's so dangerous that he can't risk his kids being there, or they're no big deal and he's wimping out.
One or the other.
One or the other.
He's a farmer. He's not a fighter. Well, I'd love to stay and chat, but you have your mission, and I have to get back to my duties. She curtsies. What?
Where can we find you for payment when it's done?
Oh, if you bring me proof that the woodpecker has left the forest or has been dispatched, then I will pay you promptly. I will be at my home, which is in the building directly next to this one. So she curtsies and then leaves the meeting hall. Hello?
Is my mic too loud, or...?
No, it's actually too quiet now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so now you guys are standing in the meeting hall. The sun is pretty much set now, so it's just you and the dancing fire.
Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Perfect. Yes.
Okay. Should we make our way to the tavern?
Let's go. I'm pumped.
Y'all lead.
Okay. So, everybody, whoosh, goes to the tavern. And in the tavern is a bunch of people. It's actually rather lively. More people than you would expect in a farming town. Sorry, hang on. I gotta switch. There. Multiple tabs. Anyway, so yeah, that's the basic layout of the tavern. I gotta remember you guys' names. Eleanor, you'll recognize the barkeep. He seems busy passing out beers.
I still wave to him.
He waves back. He's kind of busy, so he seems like he's a little, you know, quick. Like, hey, how's it going?
Hi.
You'll also notice boom. This guy sitting in the corner with a half-elf and two little elfy-looking kids. And they're off in the corner, let's say, let's say this one. There's also an elf. She seems like she's chatting up a few of the patrons. And there's two women sitting at a table. And a half-orc chowing on some stew. So what's your first move?
What corner is he in? Because it didn't pop up on my screen.
This one?
Oh, there we go. Okay.
Yeah, he's over by the booths.
Should we talk to the farmer? Or should we grab drinks first?
I mean, I'll just go with whatever you guys want to do. You guys seem like you've done this before.
Let's just get in and out before I have an aneurysm from all these people.
Straight to business, I see.
I just noticed that there's lavatories on this map.
Good to know.
Good to know the bathroom clerk.
It's the details. I steal everything from the internet, so. Anyway, so everybody's moving over to the guy with the the two kids and the half elf, right?
Sounds like it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, cool. When you get there, the guy, he looks like really, really tired, like huge bags under his eyes, just totally like out of it. He's sipping on a beer. His wife is quietly minding her stew. The kids are just kind of sitting there, like dangling their feet, like rocking them back and forth, going, ha ha, yep, mm-hmm, yep, ha ha, yep. And they seem like they're in their own little world. The old guy looks up at you guys, and he's just like, what?
We hear you have a woodpecker problem, and a monster problem, but mostly a woodpecker problem.
Don't. You guys are here to get rid of it, right?
Ideally.
All right, cool. Why are you guys here?
Because we were told that you knew about it.
Because booze costs money?
Yeah, I know about the woodpecker. Basically, about a month ago, we started hearing this loud tapping in the forest. It's gotten worse ever since. I mean, the thing's sounds like it's bringing down trees. Orange Pete, he's our logging guy. Runs a small little logging stand out in the woods. Apparently, the thing attacked him when he went to go see it. And ever since then, there's been a bunch of land hawks running around. My whole farm is pretty much covered in them. They hang out in the wheat fields. But yeah, so I had to move in here at the inn just to keep my family safe and get some sleep.
I reach out my massive hand and place it on his shoulder.
Fear not, citizen. We will surely solve your, come to your aid, fix that thing.
What he said.
Great. Listen,
yeah.
Since I'm not, you know, using it, if you guys want, I mean, it's getting kind of late, you know, it's summertime, it gets dark late. It's late now. I'm sure you guys are tired from your journey. You guys can stay at my house. Wife. He kind of like smacks the wife on the hand. Give him the keys. And she's still looking down at her food, just kind of like reaches into her pocket and like hands you guys a key. Yeah, you guys can hang out at the homestead. I'm not using it.
Thank you.
All right. Yeah, whatever. Just get rid of the thing and let me know. Don't eat any of my food.
Understood.
So, what's... that's pretty much it. He goes back to looking off into the distance. And that's pretty much all you're going to get out of him tonight, looks like. Uh-oh.
I'm not particularly good at this, but could I insight him?
What does that entail?
He seemed very disconnected.
Okay.
From what he was saying, you know, considering it's his whole livelihood.
Hang on one second. We might have some technical difficulties.
Should we do another round of tests?
Hang on. Can't hear me? Can you hear me now? Who can hear me?
I can.
You.
Okay.
Yes.
We'll hold off on 2 seconds just to get Katie back connected. Yeah, so if you want, you can use your insight while we're making this happen. So there's pretty much nothing else to say about it. He seems pretty truthful. Whatever he told you was the truth. You can tell he's definitely distraught. He's wearing his personality on his shoulder for sure.
Okay, so it's just that he's exhausted from the whole thing.
Totally. Yeah.
Okay.
He's seen some stuff.
So as well, can I possibly, because his wife is half elven. Is it possible I could speak to her in Elvish real fast?
Yes. Go for it.
So Esvel turns to his wife, gets and asks how dangerous is it, how bad are the monsters actually being right now?
How bad of who being a monster?
How dangerous are the monsters right now? Like how dangerous are they actually going to be?
As soon as you start speaking Elvish to her, she like barely glances at you for like half a second, and then she looks right back down at her food. And the kids go, haha, yep. And Lem goes, look, you got everything. Like, you know, you guys, I mean, are you going to really going to, we're trying to eat here. Come on.
So I think we've tapped everything we could out of them, so we should make our way to the homestead. Scope out the place.
All right.
That sounds great.
All right. So if you want, you guys can head on over to the, back over to the, so you guys are heading right to the house?
Yeah,
I don't think we have any reason not to.
Okay. Hang on one second. Let me get my little DM tool here.
So what did we learn? I missed it.
He gave us the key so we can stay in his house once we clear out of monsters and such.
Oh, how nice!
Mm-hmm. And the woodpecker is very large, very dangerous, and attacked the logger Orange Pete.
Oh, how awful! Okay.
I think he's okay, though. I think Orange Pete is fine.
Yeah, and then the local logger was attacked by the woodpecker, apparently.
Mm. Oh, no!
Okay, so when you guys walk on over to the farmhouse, you pass over a small bridge. There's a small stream there, not really considerable water flow, but like just enough to like turn a water wheel. That's about it. And you guys pass two giant stone silos for holding grain. One of them appears to be in disuse, and there's a fence, that's that orange line there. And there's also a tiny stone well. Hello. Oh, wait. Aha. Click. There we go. Tiny stone well, and then a modest, hand-built-looking farmhouse. It was probably built a while ago by somebody who didn't really know a whole lot about carpentry, but it's managed to stay together until now. And these things over here are wheat fields.
Could I perceive for danger?
You guys walk up to the house cautiously, and it looks like everything's okay. How are you guys lighting the way, by the way?
I have a lantern.
Okay. Lantern will work.
Hey, so what's our race layout? We have a human bard, a tiefling, and a... Tem, what are you?
Tiefling.
Tiefling. Oh, so... Is Vel? Is that how you say it?
Yes.
What are you?
Half elf.
Half elf, yes, okay.
What are you?
So, is it just our human friend that needs light?
Yes. Yeah. Okay. It's just me.
I have dark vision, so.
That's why I have the lantern.
Yeah.
Just for me. Y'all are so lucky. You know, you can see in the dark. That's amazing.
Hey, it's better to have light. Okay. So as you guys approach the farmhouse, you see a woman leaving the house. She leaves the house and unlocks the door and turns around and goes, "Whoa, oh, hey, people.
You don't look like a farmer."
"How do you know?" Okay. She does not look like a farmer. Oh, geez. It's got it right in her name. She's definitely not a farmer, guys.
Well, hello. How are you today?
Hi, I'm good. What are you guys here for?
You go first.
I was minding the Lem family house. They're staying at the inn.
That's
funny. Oh, well, we just met them.
Mention anything about you.
Oh, I'm surprised. Normally everybody's talking about me. I'm the witch in the woods, everybody's favorite talking point.
And now you've taken to house sitting.
Well, yeah, kinda. Yeah. Plus, they have, like, food and stuff in there. It's gonna spoil.
Aren't there monsters around here?
Yep, like a few landhawks.
Oh. Whatever. Wow. Are you gonna help us? Are you gonna help us get the woodpecker?
Like 2 seconds ago, you just accused me of being a thief.
We never called you a thief. We just said you wanted farming.
Yeah, it was implied.
I mean, I assumed she was a thief.
Yeah. See.
Or just put us out there like that, I guess.
That was wrong, admittedly.
What was that?
A bit suspicious sneaking around.
I didn't quite hear what Cassie said.
I said I was wrong, admittedly, but you're still suspicious.
Oh yeah, no, I'll give you that. I'm totally suspicious. I would suspect me, I'll put it that way. So
you're going to help us?
Help you with what?
To get the woodpecker, silly.
Why? It's just doing what great woodpeckers do.
We're all being paid to get rid of it, so.
What was that? I didn't... Your mic's a little low, Cassie.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, sorry.
I mean, she's got a point. I mean, we're only going after the woodpecker because we're told to, right?
Money can be exchanged for good services.
Yeah, that's what we're doing.
Woodpecker's noises are driving monsters out of the woods and forcibly relocating people. I think that's going well beyond the stretch of what a woodpecker does.
I see your point. Alright. I'll think about it. I have a hut not too far from here. If you guys are really dead set on finding this great woodpecker and everything like that, then just swing by my hut in the morning and I might be able to do something.
In the morning? I thought we're going right now.
Oh, it's like almost midnight. What do you...
Oh.
You don't want to go into the forest at nighttime. It's not just scary. It's actually dangerous.
Oh. Well, thanks for letting us know that. See, when you say people talk about you, they must be saying a lot of nice things.
I think they're just racist towards witches.
Oh.
Or not racist, prejudiced, I should say.
I was like, I didn't know you could be witches or race.
Well, I'm sorry people are being really mean to you, and they shouldn't, and I'm sorry.
Well, I appreciate your kindness. You guys must be from a city somewhere.
You could say that.
Sure.
I am.
All right, well, I'll see you guys in the morning if I see you, and if not, then whatever. And she kind of grabs a sack next to her and heads off to her hut.
I have a feeling that sack was empty when she entered.
Yeah, but she already admitted she was taking food, so.
I won't tell anyone if you don't.
I don't care one way or the other. The farmer's not who's paying us.
I mean, she's right. It will go bad if nobody eats it.
I leave this discussion behind and go on like that.
Okay, so the front door is locked, but the key works. So if you guys wanted to go inside the house, that's up to you guys.
I definitely do.
Yes. All right. Going inside seems like a good idea.
Okay, so, okay, so it is late. But what's everybody's action as of right now inside the house? It's just a normal farmhouse, nothing to talk about. Really, nothing valuable. Just like basic stuff.
Is it a one-story house or a two-story house?
It's a two-story house. There is a one-bedroom upstairs.
Should we draw straws for who gets the bed?
Wouldn't there be a couple of beds, right?
Yeah, there's actually one large bed for enough for two people, and then there's two smaller beds enough for like a really small person or a dwarf.
I'm small. Ish. I don't know if I'm kid size, but
I am used to not having the comforts of life. I will use the smaller one as a pillow.
Oh,
and I
stalk
over to it.
Okay.
So, does everybody go to bed, or are we setting up a watch, or what?
I think we'll watch. I don't sleep much, and I have dark vision, so I can take the first one.
Okay. Hang on a second here.
I try to find a comfortable blanket. And put it over. Lion says that that's how. I'm sorry, I feel like I'm echoing.
Yeah, I'm getting a bit of an echo too.
Oh, damn
it
to me. My volume's being weird.
It's okay. I was like, wait, is that me? Is that talking twice?
For emphasis.
Wait, okay, so you said you're... I feel like I'm bad. I'm shit at pronouncing names, guys. So you said your name was Blythe?
Bilge.
Bilge? I don't know what I just wrote.
Like bulge, but not quite.
B-I-L-G-E.
It's like the part of a ship.
Yeah, I spelled it like that, but I guess I'm just... I don't pronounce. Anyways, Bilge. I find you a nice, comfortable blanket and put it over you.
Aww.
And... Someone staying up for watch?
Yes, I am. Up for watch.
Are you able to do that all night as a special super duper person, or are we taking shifts?
If you want to take shifts, we can, but I can definitely handle one night of no sleep.
Do you have the trance thing, or is that...
Oh, this is the personality trait. Insomnia.
Oh, no, we can definitely do shifts. also, I definitely locked the door. Before we go to sleep.
Okay. I was going to ask that, too.
Good instincts.
I'll take second watch.
Okay.
Or the other half. as the case may be.
Yeah, it'll be 5 a.m. So it's like two shifts is gonna do it. And let me just make some rules here. Okay. So Temerity, while you're on your watch, you notice, and it's especially apparent with your dark vision, you notice a strange greenish glowing coming from the well.
Okay, so should I go check that out is the question. Let's see. Okay. I will go check out the well, I suppose.
Okay. You notice that there's something, it's difficult to see because it's, a deep well, but there's something at the bottom that seems to be emanating, or emitting a greenish glow. It seems to be a small object. And there is a bucket inside the well.
Okay. So, how is the well filled with, like, water, or is it just, like, an empty well with some glowing shit at the bottom of it?
It's got water at the bottom, and beneath the water is the object. And if you had to guess, it's probably going to be inside the bucket.
Okay. So I pull up the bucket then.
Okay. And it's just you, right? It's just you by yourself?
Yes.
Okay. So everybody else pretend like you don't hear this.
I'm sleeping.
Okay. So inside the bucket, you find a thing. Hang on one second. Let me see if... Can I do this? Hang on. I'm trying to feature. I forgot how to do whispers. So yeah, you find, an amulet. Oh. Okay, so you find an amulet.
That's ominous.
How's the mic situation going?
Working on it.
Okay. So you find an amulet, and inside the amulet is a gem that's green and glowing, and it's like pulsing like a heart. And you can hear very soft, intelligible whispers coming from it.
That sounds like something I should not be touching. Can I, like, just keep the thing in the bucket and not touch it with my hands?
Sure.
Okay, because that's what I'm going to do. That genuinely.
So, the bucket's filled with water. You can pour the water out or whatever, but it remains in the bucket.
Okay. So, I don't know if this is safe to bring inside, is the thing. Could I, like, do a roll to figure out if it's, like, super dangerous to bring into the house?
Hold
weapons and stuff.
Do you have, like, a detect magic spell or something?
I don't think I do.
Well, it definitely looks magical.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't have anything for that stuff. Okay. Oh, okay. Did the amulet just scream, or was that a glitch?
Sorry.
Cassie.
Sorry.
The amulet has just screamed.
It is whispering. No, it doesn't sound like that, though.
So it's just unintelligible, so I can't, like, pick out any words from it. Like, kill your all of your friends.
Hang on one second. Let me see what languages you speak.
Where are your friends?
I mean, like...
Do, do, do. No, you don't notice any... you don't notice anything that you understand. It could be a different language. It might be just gibberish. You don't really know.
How does this sound?
This perfect. Is fine. Okay. So there's whispering. I'm going to keep it in the water just in case I'm like drowning any evil magic out, but like most likely not. But let's just keep it in the water for safekeeping. Okay. So I will bring the bucket into the house. I don't want to leave it outside the door. Can I like leave it outside the door and then like go and wake someone up?
As you start walking to the door, you notice that the rope is getting shorter and shorter and shorter, and it probably won't make it all the way inside the house.
All right. That means I need to wake somebody up then. Okay. I don't have a knife.
Yeah, it's also probably not a good idea to cut somebody's well bucket.
Oh. Collateral damage, okay. But, yeah, we'll leave the well bucket then. And then I go inside the house.
Okay.
And, oh boy. So I'm just gonna assume I know nothing about anyone. But I'm gonna wake up Esvel, because she speaks Elven. Like, because we heard her speak Elven. Mm-hmm. Elvish, whatever. And I feel like if I don't understand it, then there might be a better chance that she might. And she seems, I don't know, knowledgeable about stuff, I guess. She's got this knowledgeable air, so I'm going to wake her up and ask her about the weird shit in the bucket.
Okay.
So,
hey, you, elf, wake up. Wake up.
Call me elf one more time and a dagger's going in your throat.
Okay, ma'am. Wake up. I need... Well, I don't need it, but I feel like there's something that I need to bring to your attention.
What?
What is your knowledge about weird glowing necklaces and such?
I mean, I can find the knowledge.
I mean, like, how quickly? Because there's one outside, and...
Yep! Did you have to bring it in the house?
I didn't bring it in the house. It's in a bucket outside the house.
Okay, just take me to it, please.
Okay. All right. Okay, so I take it out to the bucket. I just kept it in the water because I feel like if it's weird magic, maybe I can drown it out in the water.
Then why are you asking me?
Who else? Who else is there that I can...
Okay, so... So let's just say that it's not in the water, because I just realized it would sound really weird if it was talking through the water. So it's sitting at the bottom of a dry bucket.
Okay.
And Esvel, you notice that you catch like a couple words in Abyssal, but you're not sure, like they don't make sense the way that they're structured. So it's kind of like you just catch like one or two words. And they're mostly like things like they sound like they're commands. I'll put it that way. But they don't make sense.
So I guess Esvel tries to talk back to it in Abyssal.
All right. What do you say?
What did you just say? Like she asked. She asked the amulet, "What did it just say?"
So you're asking an amulet, what did it just say?
Yes.
Okay. It continues to whisper gibberish.
Can't believe
that. That does no help.
I just say this under my breath. Because this is an odd thing to witness. A woman speaking to a necklace.
How did you know it? How did you find it?
It was glowing out of the wall as I was looking out the window, and I felt like it was something that I should probably look at.
Hmm.
That's basically the extent of the interactions I've had with this thing of unknown origin.
What made you want to approach a glowing well, exactly?
And what? Leave it?
I mean, it wasn't doing anything otherwise.
I mean,
necklace. Maybe I can... I don't know. Oh! Oh, shit.
Everything's broken up. Okay, is everything okay? Oh, good.
I hear you.
All right.
Can everybody hear me?
Yes.
Good job. Right.
Okay.
Yep.
I clicked the button and it did something.
Oh.
Never click buttons.
It's the amulet. Shit.
Okay, so...
I just, you know, like, I feel like ominous glowing should be addressed because it might bite us in the ass if we leave it unattended.
Just so you know, it's speaking of fizzle.
That sounds like it's important, but I don't know what that means.
But none of it makes goddamn sense. It's a bizzle, I can hear it, but people don't speak a bizzle that way.
Yeah.
But if they were to, could you guess what it's trying to say?
It's giving a command, but it's not one that either of us are hearing.
Is it kill? Is the command kill is what I'm asking.
The words are command, like action words. So they're like I said, they're just kind of gibberish. If anything, it sounds like they're just like very basic. Like they're not complex.
Like what kind of actions are we talking? Like run and jump and
stuff like that, yeah.
All right.
Well,
but this brings up two questions. Does the farmer own this amulet? Or does it have to do something with the witch that was just snooping around like 10 minutes, like a few hours ago? I'm just... Either way, I feel like this thing should not be where I found it.
No, it shouldn't be.
It definitely looks out of place at a farm. In the All middle right. of nowhere.
Okay, I don't want to be that person, but I'm going just to put just a little bit of money that the witch left it here. I know this sounds really bad, but I don't think our pal the farmer has come into contact with things that chant languages that are beyond our comprehension, is what I'm saying.
If that... It's possible it's neither of them either, too.
Okay, so that means somebody came to a monster-infested farm to drop off a necklace at a wishing well.
We came to a monster-infested farm for gold.
I mean, if you want to put us out there like that, I guess. But... why this farm and why this well? Aren't there dozens of less monster-infested farmhouses they could have probably dropped this baby off at? I'm just saying. It's weird. It's peculiar.
I'll make a note of the amulet. It's a little word to say. Maybe we can find the library.
Okay. Are you guys going to leave it in the bucket?
I'm not touching it with my hands. You can touch it.
I'm going to put it back in the well.
Yeah, let's just we'll put it back.
Okay.
And let it hang out.
Alright, so the amulet splashes into the amulet in the bucket splash into the bottom of the well. It makes a very satisfying sound, but nothing unusual. And the well continues to glow.
Well, we're going to go to bed.
Yeah, go back to bed.
For our own survival sake, I'm going back to bed.
That'd be a good idea.
On your way in, you notice that some of the wheat is like kind of swishing and swaying in like a pattern away from you. And you can kind of see... who's seen Jurassic Park 2?
Yeah, with the velociraptors?
Yeah, you see that, like, going away from you.
Oh. That's ominous.
No, turns to, Laura, what's your character name again?
Temerity. You can call me that.
Temerity's just like, keep an eye on the wheat fields.
Yeah, I way ahead of you on that, yes.
Good.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. So.
So you guys, returning to your sleeping patterns and the schedule?
Yes.
Okay. Hang on 1 second. Okay. You notice, actually it would be, whose watch is it? Bilge.
Bilge.
When on your watch, you hear some, hooting off to the east. Oh, by the way, on my map, north is east. I mean, north is up.
Yes.
So in like the east fields, you hear some, hooting, and then in the west fields, you hear some more hooting. Yeah, like right over there, and then like you hear like a resounding or an answering call over there, and that's about it. You just hear some noises, and some kind of, it's like a hooting bark hiss.
Could I roll nature to see if that's?
Yeah. Why not? That would be like a wisdom or something, right? Or a nature.
Nature is intelligence.
Okay.
Survival system. I don't know.
Cool.
Yep.
It definitely sounds like hooting.
The natural night noises.
Also, if you could go into your settings, and I don't know if is there a way to turn off
3D dice I just did.
Rolling advantage. If you go into your character sheet and click on the settings. Yeah. It should be always roll or something.
Like never roll for advantage or something.
Right.
Would you guys find that setting?
It's on your character sheet, and then in the little, there's a little red gear button.
Oh, here it is. Yeah.
Cool. Okay, so in the morning, even before the sun rises, you guys hear what must clearly be the woodpecker. It's just tapping, like...
I assume that'd be the woodpecker.
Well, let's go get it.
Esmeralda kind of half wakes up and she just looks annoyed at everything.
Yeah, it is definitely annoying.
I get up and I run out the front door.
Okay.
I'm excited.
A plan of attack.
They're at the front door.
Yeah, I would recommend some sort of planning for sure. You guys are all level one, right?
Yes.
Yep.
Yeah.
Somebody can stop me on my way to the door.
Stop.
Huh?
We should all talk about what we should do to the woodpecker. Also, we have to see our friend Fallon, right? You like Fallon. We have to stop by her place.
Oh, yeah.
Just remember.
Yeah, I know. I just get excited about stuff and, you know, just want to go.
I know. It's exciting. It's exciting. Adventuring is exciting.
I know. This is my first time, going out on an adventure.
Oh, great.
Yeah, and...
I know. It's great, right? She's excited.
And we here want to make sure your adventure is the best it possibly can be. So... we, as a unit and as a team, should probably go and stop by Fallon's, talk to her about things, woodpeckers, and then we can go and stop the thing and then get her money, which is, I think everyone will agree, is the best course of action. Well,
that sounds like a great idea. All right, leader, let's go.
Okay, so I guess we make our way to Fallon's hut.
Okay.
I locked the door behind us.
Yes, lock the door.
Okay.
Good thinking, Bilge.
So, when you guys arrive at Fallon's hut, there's a note pinned to the door. It looks like the hut's been built out of like sticks, in a way that like doesn't look like it would have been possible to build it by hand. There must have been something else helping to build it, like magic or something.
Just a guess.
It's just like a crazy looking house made out of like sticks and branches and no like actual lumber. And there's a strong aroma of like various herbs and spices, possibly even, you know, psychotropic type stuff. It smells like three head shops smashed together.
Wow. This place is cool.
Yes, cool. Could certainly describe it.
I don't know.
Possibly. It's
remote.
And there's a raven on top of the hut, and it goes, cool, cool.
Oh, look at that. It's so cute.
I knock on the door, just for matter's sake.
It, like, swings open lazily when you knock it.
Yes.
The note that was pinned there is just kind of flapping in the breeze.
What does the note say, by the way?
The note says, I need Quicksilver. Go get some from the old mill.
Okay, so...
offer is money, so let's just...
Enter.
Well, it's not addressed to us.
Yeah, that is true. So we should just enter the hut. Since the door is open, the bird is calling, and I've talked. She must know we're coming in.
It was a good time to set up traps.
Does anybody have detect traps?
I think you're thinking of a different system.
Are we metagaming now?
The open door, through the open door, you can see...
your perception roll?
I think, well...
If you're very perceptive, you could look around the room and see if there's any kind of kooky stuff that's around, but I trust this girl a lot. Like, look.
Well, there's a large fire inside that's lighting any shadows that you would see, so there's enough sunlight and everything pouring into this place. It's like Hagrid's hut. But instead of a table in the middle of the room, there's like a giant cauldron with a fire underneath it and some very strong, nasty vapors coming from it.
A little on the nose, isn't she? A little bit.
There's also coffee. Like herbs and spices hanging from the ceiling and a few like dead squirrels and like rabbit pelts and some like huge, massive like eagle feathers. Kind of clumped up and various what are they called? Dream catchers with strange symbols patterned inside them, some carvings on the wall, on wooden plates.
I see all this and don't enter.
And I join him.
Okay.
Can I just take a quick like look see inside? It's obvious that she's not home, I feel.
Correct.
She's not home. Well, it's obvious she's not home, and I feel like even if she was, she wouldn't be as much help as we think she'd be.
The raven lands on your shoulder, looks inside the house, and goes, not home, not home.
Thank you, dear friend.
Man, this raven's really cool.
Cool, cool.
Yeah.
Well, all right. So if she's not home.
Hail Satan.
All right, Raven. I think it's time for you to vamoose back to your post.
Okay. So the raven flies off. It squawks angrily at you and takes off towards the woods.
Okay, so we have no outside help. It's just us and our wits.
So we definitely should figure out a plan.
The logger was attacked by the bird.
And I have a feeling we will also be attacked by this bird.
Are any of y'all, like, really nature-type people and get out a lot in the woods and stuff?
I grew up in a city.
Oh.
I grew up on a ship.
Ooh.
The type of nature I've grown up in really doesn't cover woods and...
Oh, okay.
I guess we're fucked then.
I mean, what other choice do we have? I'm like, it's a bird. It's a very large bird, but it's also a bird. There has to be a way that we could stop it. I mean,
we can just go walk around the woods. It sounds fun.
Is it still making noise at this point?
No. The woodpecking is constant.
Like, it's incessant.
Yeah, so, incessant.
Can we go towards the noise?
You can.
Let's go towards the noise.
Talk to the logger first. You'll at least know how it fights and what we'll be against.
That is true. He is the one person, at least the assumed person, who has actually seen and interacted with.
I think we've talked to enough people.
Well, but I like people.
Agree.
When you guys were heading towards the witch's hut, let's just say that you guys surveyed a bit of the surrounding area, and you can tell all of the farmer's property. You guys did like a perimeter sweep, and you guys saw this little logging hut off in the distance, and that would be in the direction of the tapping.
See, he's on the way. Like, look. Tapping. Log hut. We can just stop in. Have a chat. Maybe a bit of tea. We don't have to have tea. But we should probably talk to Orange Pete. That is my personal and professional opinion.
Okay, what's the plan?
I vote we go see the logger. Either he's there and he talks to us, or he's a pain in the ass and we start wreck where we are now.
Yes.
Okay.
We honestly have nothing to lose.
Fine.
Listen, I hate people too, but I want to survive this.
Don't worry, Bilge. We'll get our hands on that. Woodpecker, don't worry. You'll get your...
I can play you a song if it makes you feel better.
Sure.
Okay. I hit my drums a little bit, and I'm like, okay. I'm like, hey, we're on an adventure. It's gonna be fun. And, we're here, and we're going after the woodpecker. And I don't have anything else to say.
Can this just be, like, the best song ever? Like, even though it sounds exactly like this, we're like, fuck yeah, right?
Yeah, roll a performance, skill check.
Okay.
Let's see if you tuned your drums properly today.
Let's go get this woodpecker, y'all.
So the performance is exceptionally good for a drum solo. And it's,
lit.
You guys notice a little bit more pep in your step, and it makes the journey seem pretty short. But it's quickly interrupted when you see a half-orc heading towards town.
Hmm.
He has a giant axe on his back, and he's carrying a big old backpack full of stuff.
That's bigger than mine.
Yeah, it's clearly a wood-cutting axe, not a people-cutting axe.
I feel like that's the man we need to talk to.
Is he orange?
Is he Orange Pete?
No, he is green-ish.
Maybe he's Green Pete.
He'll be wrong, though.
I, like, wave and say, excuse me, sir, with the log. Like, just, like, try to get his attention.
When he sees you waving, he he drops his sack, and he slams his wood axe into a stump next to him, and he pulls cotton out of his ears. Sorry, what?
Are you the logger, by chance?
Yep, that's me.
All right. We are the adventurers hired to handle your little woodpecker problem.
Good, I hate that thing.
I agree. Awful thing. And you said you were attacked by said woodpecker, and we would just want to be able to do this as efficiently as possible. So if you could just recount the events that occurred that day, that would be really helpful to us
getting rid of the woodpecker. So I went over to see this woodpecker, and it's this like big thing, and it's got a giant beak, and all these like little landhawk things like came out and like attacked me. So like the woodpecker kind of flew off when he saw me, but he came right back, and the hawks bit my leg, and he like lifts up his pants, and you see this like giant bite mark. It looks like a dog bite on his leg.
So wait, the landhawks attacked you along with the woodpecker?
Yeah, it like got real angry and then like flew away.
Okay.
But it came back.
Did it seem like the woodpecker may be controlling the landhawks? If you were making an educated guess.
Well, they're not like friends, but like they're not like enemies, like they hang out or something. I don't know. It's all confusing, man. This is really, like, I haven't slept in like 2 days. I just came to get my stuff out of the hut, and I'm going right back into town, staying at the inn.
All right. We'll let you be on, unless anybody else on the team has other questions for him, as I feel like.
You might want to correct the inn on the fact that you are green and not orange.
Oh, yeah. No, I ate an orange once, and everybody just started calling me that.
That's a cool nickname.
Well, Orange Pete, we should be letting you go. Hopefully you can get some sleep soon, and the rest of the town.
Alright, see you later. And he stuffs the cotton balls back into his ears and heads on back into town.
Alright, so it seems that we are also dealing with landhawks as well as woodpecker. That seems like a problem.
I think we're a pretty swell team, and we can face anything that comes our way.
I'm just making very pensive thinking noises, I'm sorry.
So onward, then?
I guess onward. Possibly
upward. Okay. As you guys continue east past the logged trees, that's what these dots are, you guys enter the deep woods. At some point, you come across a clearing that's been, there's like knocked down trees. It looks like a volcano exploded. And I revealed the whole map, didn't I? Look at that.
It's okay.
I mean, all I see are dots and trees. Trees. That's all I...
Let's say who's got the most perception? I wrote it down.
My passive is 9.
That's not enough. Bilge.
I know, it sucks.
Bilge, you notice that there's...
I do? Oh god, that's not good, guys. That's not good, guys.
Let's say you guys are... Oh, wait, no, hang on.
Grab. No, mine's 12. What am passive. I
doing? Mine's 13.
Okay. Oh, Jesus Christ.
Let's say... Hang on.
Wait for perception?
No, passive wisdom.
Oh. No, not your passive wisdom. Your perception.
Oh, okay.
Aren't those the same thing? Passive wisdom and perception? I don't...
Yeah, what's the difference? I don't know. Hang on.
Oh. It's passive versus active, so you could be more actively perceptive.
Right. Passive is like, you know, you're just walking through the woods and you spot something out of the corner of your eye, where active is like, you guys are like looking for it. I think. That's how I understand it.
Would that be your wisdom stat then? Like, or is it like one of those like?
There's a box for it.
It's based off your wisdom stat. Like perception is like when you want to look for some, when you want to look at something, and then passive is like you're just walking around and the DM's like, hey, you notice this?
Okay.
Right.
Because you're that alert shit.
Yeah.
Okay. So. Those are apparently alert. I'm using Bilge's icon just for now. But you guys are, like, right about here, by the trees. And you guys notice that there's a clearing with a bunch of broken trees, and a giant pile of sawdust. And a giant, massive tree. A giant, it's like an oak tree.
Mm-hmm.
And on the side of this oak tree, clutching it with its very strange, gangly-looking claws, is... Oh, hang on. A giant woodpecker.
Right by it, basically.
Oh, my.
Oh, there it is.
Whoa, that's a bazillion times bigger than me.
Yeah, it's big.
Like, how many, like, approximately, how close, like... Super close? Like, we're right by it? Or, like...
No, it's on the tree. It appears to have made a giant sawdust nest.
Suddenly, Shadow of the Colossus.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, maybe not, but...
I thought when I read the sign that it was, like, a woodpecker, like... The itty-bitty ones.
No, this thing's about 15 feet high when it's standing on its legs. Good. And it probably has, like, a 40-foot wingspan.
I'm a little nervous, but stand tall.
And it's just going to town on this tree. It's carving a giant hole in it.
I mean,
why is it so big?
Are we gonna?
I assume magic of some kind, but.
I was gonna mention along the way. You guys noticed some land hawks hanging out in the trees. They weren't bothering you. You weren't bothering them. They were just kind of sitting in the tree, perched like a cat, just watching you walk along the woods.
Okay, so...
But there's none here right now.
So it's, as far as we can tell, it's just us and the woodpecker right now? Yeah.
But that could easily change. Possibly.
Correct.
Okay. Let's get a jump on it.
And
I sneak. as best as I can sneak.
Oh, boy.
Maybe I can sneak around and investigate it a bit more?
Okay.
Let's look for weak points first.
This thing is certainly intimidating, I'll put it that way.
Can we, look for weak points on it? Like, does it have any really squishy bits that we can just... go to town on?
I mean, its leathery wings look fragile, but, you know, getting a good hit on them is going to be a little tricky because it's, ow.
They're big.
Sorry. Yeah, they're big. It's a big thing. It's a big thing.
Okay.
Can I roll for stealth to try to get in closer to it? To see if there's anything more obvious?
I mean,
we die.
You can roll for stealth.
How do I do that on this?
Hang on, I don't know if...
It's on your character sheet and your skill box?
Yep.
Oh, dear.
Oh, god damn it. Sorry, I have to, X out of it.
Are we all rolling for stealth?
Could we?
Oh, cool.
Oh, boy.
What do you expect?
This is bad.
I missed it. What happened? Hang on. Sorry. I was
nothing. Nothing happened.
Trying to manage my windows here, and I'm.
We haven't rolled anything yet.
Done anything?
I rolled for stealth, and I got.
Okay, so when you roll your one, a tree branch That sounds like it was meant to be broken. Snaps the loudest it's ever snapped. Like, this sounds like a firecracker. And the woodpecker just turns around and looks directly at you and, like, catches you in, like, your mid sneak pose.
Because on my screen, I rolled higher than that.
Oh, wait, hang on.
When it's red, it tells you it's a natural one.
Yeah.
It still adds more modifiers, even though it's still a natural fail.
Okay.
The woodpecker spots the whole party, and it just starts screaming and flapping its wings, and it gets down on the ground and just starts charging at you.
I pull out my axe and I get ready.
Can I roll to dodge the charge?
It's not quite at you yet. So this would be when everybody rolls their initiative.
Alrighty.
Okay. First time, guys, let's go.
Okay.
Initiative?
How do we roll initiative?
Sorry. You click on initiative.
Oh, there it is. I see it.
Oh man, we are so ready. We're the readiest. Woo!
Okay.
I had time, sweetie.
Okay. Oh, by the way, Laura, if you click on your name in the bottom right, you can change it to your character name if you.
Oh, yay. Yeah. Sorry, Abby.
That's good.
Who has.
I got a 4.
10.
It's dexterity, right? So we're going off of that. So
we are not a wise or dexterous bunch, are
okay.
we?
So it's going to go Lore, then... Oh, wait, hang on. Who's got the higher dex? Yeah. It's going to go Lore, and then Espel, then Bilge, and...
Eleanor.
And then Eleanor. And then the woodpecker.
Wow, the woodpecker lost that.
Yeah, the woodpecker rolled like a 2.
Oh, thank God. Oh, okay. Okay, so it's far away. It's not right up at us, right?
No, not yet.
Okay, so can I use my... I'm going to use my sling.
Okay.
Just... aim at it. Like, use my sling, I guess.
That hits.
Oh, yeah.
So, the rocker, whatever it was that you... The what were you slinging at him?
A really nice, heavy rock.
Okay. So the rock hits the woodpecker, and he takes... how much damage? Click on the word sling.
Click on it. Do I just
click on sling, and then it will roll damage for you? I think. Nope.
Sorry. Click on sling in the chat.
Oh, yeah. Bobby. I'm not good at this game.
There you go.
Cool. He seems unfazed. Like it hit his beak, and he's like. Meh.
Oh, that's not a good sign.
And you guys, while this is happening, you hear some hooting going on in the forest beyond. But,
more ominous noises.
Well, nothing more ominous than you've heard before. Maybe this stirred up a few animals in the forest. So who's next? Espel, yes.
Okay, so I take one of my daggers and try to throw it at the beast's eye.
Okay, go for it.
Oh, I cannot hear Cassie. Oh,
natural 20. Roll again.
Okay. Pulling back. There's so many boxes. Again.
Did you just roll two 20s?
Yeah. Let me check to make sure.
Is Esfel God?
I have. You want me to try again just to see if it does it a third time and see if it's an issue?
No, no, you only need 220s to auto kill.
Just kill the thing. Did Esfel just carry this team to victory?
Yeah, you throw your dagger at the woodpecker, and the knife just goes straight through his eye and into his brain. There's no way of getting that knife back, but the woodpecker just crashes to the ground.
Straight up.
Wow!
Single-handedly lobotomized a giant woodpecker.
And now the hooting gets a lot louder.
Oh.
I guess we should leave.
Should we go? Yeah. I mean, we've done our job here. We should probably take something as a trophy, though, to prove that we literally just murdered this thing. Well, as well murdered this thing.
This is go.
But don't we need proof that we killed it?
Yeah, the proof is that the sound is going to stop.
But, like, can we just take, like, a feather? We can just take one really quick. And then
Looting gets really loud.
Okay, we should just go.
And it's coming from all over.
Okay, we're running now.
As you guys start running into the trees, you notice that there are a lot of landhawks perched on the tree branches doing that butt wiggle thing cats do.
Oh, God.
It looks like they're going to pounce.
I feel like we have upset a delicate balance in nature. And
whoops.
This is nature striking back.
And now they're doing that barking thing that they do in Jurassic Park when they walk into the kitchen.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, you know what? Hang on one second. Let me roll something here.
That's never good.
Two of you noticed that not only are there landhawks in the trees doing the butt wiggle thing, but there's also two, like, right next to you in the bushes.
Which two of us?
The two most clever girls. I'm making a Jurassic Park joke.
I know. Yeah. I know. I resent you for it.
It doesn't really matter which two. You can just kind of, like, nudge the others and be like, hey, they're around us. They're everywhere.
Oh, this isn't good.
Let's stand and fight.
That sounds like a bad idea.
Buddy, I admire your tenacity and your will, but we are massively, massively outnumbered.
Well, I mean, did you see how well that first one went?
He's right. We did pretty good.
Oh, yeah. All right, you've got me there, but I have a feeling our luck is about to run out.
How about we keep running?
I like that plan. I like that plan, not being in the spot we are right now.
Towards the landhawks that are in the trees or towards the ones that are right behind you?
Are you telling me you're going to have to fight every single one of these things?
He's upset that his boss monster is dead.
Go do it, guys.
I'm sorry.
Hey, they really like the woodpecker, is all. It's like you killed their best friend.
What?
What?
Oh, God. The landhawks, they've gotten him.
Yeah, I'm not sure what rule variants he's using, but this is usually why you don't do auto death.
I like auto death.
Okay. I mean,
nothing is better than having a wizard give a monologue for like 2 minutes about how awful and evil he's going to be to a townsfolk, and then having one person like auto crit with a dagger.
At level one,
I know it's
fucking Christ. Oh,
okay.
He's back.
He's back.
Okay. So there's two in the bushes, and they jump out, and they're going to take swipes at...
okay, I hear him.
Are you here, everybody?
Katie is having to fix, because she can't hear you, apparently.
Say something again?
Okay.
Yep, here you go.
Oh no, Blake!
What's happening?
So the woodpecker's dead.
Yeah, I know that. Yeah.
That's good.
Drop my d20.
Oh.
All right. Well, you know what? We'll just do this. So the landhawk is going to. There's two landhawks behind you guys, and one's going to attack. Aspel, and one's going to attack Bilge.
No, no!
And we got these.
Oh, God.
What? Oh, hang on. There we go. Okay, so the first one's going to attack... actually, wait, hang on. I should undo that. Forget the second roll. So, the first one's going to attack Aspel. Does an 8 hit.
Okay, let's see. Oh god, I have 9. What the fuck?
Your AC is 12. So, that does not hit.
Oh, okay.
Alright, and then the second one attacks Bilge for... Let's see, that's a 22.
Huh, yeah, I think that might hit.
Yep.
I think you fucked, my dude.
So it does... 5 damage.
Okay, alright.
And we'll just keep the order from last time. So it is Temerity?
Mm-hmm.
Well, yeah, I also got a 9 initiative.
Are we
starting at the beginning? Top of the round?
Okay, yeah, we're going to start at the beginning again.
Gotcha.
So, Cassie's is an honor. Okay, so how close are these landhawks to me, personally?
If everybody's, like, bunched up in a circle, they're right outside the circle. They're within a few feet.
Close enough to punch is what I'm asking.
Yes, definitely. Okay. You can move in and punch in the same
So I'm going to unarmed strike... the closest landhawk to me personally. Just
okay. 8.
I think that head did it.
Where did I put the armor class? No, 8 does not hit.
I just swing it air, just like fuck.
It brushes its feathers and it looks flustered but not hurt.
Guys, I got him on tilt. Don't worry.
Okay.
You're doing great.
And next is Esfel.
So I go to shoot the one nearest to me with my short bow.
Go for it.
Auto kill. Auto kill.
16 does hit.
Wait.
So click on the word short bow.
Oh, okay. Short bow.
There you go. Okay, so that does 14.
I think the plus 5 is the crit. That's a crit damage.
Oh yeah, you're right. Wait.
If you mouse
6
over
plus it. 2, you're right. Okay. So 8 damage. Yeah, it's you still have advantage rolling on. That's why.
I do?
Looks yeah. Like it.
I had turned it off.
It might have come back on.
Double check.
I'm not seeing advantage being on in my settings here at all.
Hmm. Hang on.
Is it like roll queries? You have never roll advantage?
I fix. Okay. It should be fixed.
Thank you.
Okay. Next is going to be Bilge.
I retaliate at the one that got me.
Okay. That will be Landhawk 2.
Landhawk number 2. Bill's just having a bad day.
Swing and a miss, and it leaves you unable to do a second action this turn. You just kind of go, whoa, and have to collect yourself.
Yeah.
Pride is booze.
Okay, and last we have Eleanor.
I want to... Which one looks the most hurt?
Landhawk 1, the one that attacked Esvel.
Attack that one. Can I viciously mock that one?
Oh my god, yes.
Sure, yeah.
Alright, I'm gonna be like...
The Landhawk.
Hey, bad guy, look my way, evildoer. Not today. I'm gonna do a drum solo with these beats I play, because my crew is cool, and damn, we slay. And I'm going to viciously mock them. So they have to do a wisdom save.
Yes.
Oh my god. Please tell me you killed them with this roast. Indeed. One large dark roast.
dropping dice everywhere. There we go. Despite not being able to speak your language, it definitely looks thrown off.
Yeah, as long as they can hear me, they don't have to speak my language.
Yeah. It's like looking at its claws like, what am I even doing here? Like, what is life? Okay. So, once I dropped all my dice. Okay. So, Landhawk number 1 is going to attack. It's going to bite at...
Wait, did it save?
No, it's definitely not saving.
Okay, so then it takes those 4 damage, and also it has disadvantage on the next attack roll it makes before the end of its next turn.
Okay.
Cool.
So, this one is going to bite at Temerity.
Oh, cool. My armor class is 11, exactly.
Okay, it, like, gets a good hold of you, like a dog biting, like, a jacket. It just kind of goes, and that's about it.
That's peculiar. That's... quite a problem that I have on my hands.
It doesn't hurt, but it definitely hit your armor or whatever you have wearing, your boots. And the next one is going to take a claw swipe at Bilge.
Oh boy, Bilge. Oh boy.
Yeah, just send all the high rolls my way, you know?
Oh boy.
Thanks. Oh, I'll take them.
I'm rolling a d4. Okay, so it does 6 damage.
And I'm down.
That's it?
That's it.
God. Oh. You are pretty low health.
Well, at 0, you're just, like, unconscious.
Right.
Oh, my God. Oh,
you're
So you took, what, 5 last time?
Yep.
Okay. So it knocks you down, and you're... pretty much down for the count. But you're not, like, bleeding out or anything.
If these are like the little tiny birds, what even was that giant bird going to do to us?
It'll be built.
Plus 6 to hit?
Thankfully, we don't have to know that now.
At least we accidentally auto-killed the big one.
So, before you guys kind of get going, you notice that the 2 Landhawks that were attacking you guys both grab a hold of Bilge by his boots or his shirt or something like that and start dragging him off into the forest.
Oh, no.
Wait, they, like, automatically just get to drag him? We don't get a chance to do anything about that?
They start to. They haven't actually left the circle yet, so.
Okay.
Cool.
So who's next?
Whose turn is it?
It's me.
Yeah. Okay, so can I attack... Are they still in punching range?
Yes. You can run up to them and punch them.
Okay, hold on. So I'm going to go and punch the one of the ones that has a hold on my buddy Bilge.
Okay.
Oh.
13, I believe, does hit.
Okay, so...
Okay, so that one just kind of like gets knocked out and falls to the ground. It's not moving anymore.
Sleep, and then I say sleep tight as I punch him in the head.
It like blood comes out of its mouth. You're pretty sure it's not sleeping.
Yes. I love to punch things to death.
And next we have Esvel.
I guess I'll just go for my short bow again and try to hit the last one that's dragging me.
Okay.
Try to crit.
Oh no, I can't hear gas.
That definitely does hit.
Sweet! So it needs to be short bow again?
Mm-hmm. Okay. 7. That... It hits it right in the neck, kind of goes, and falls to the ground, like, starts scratching at the arrow, and it eventually just sort of stops and dies.
Okay.
Well, Bills is okay, I guess.
And the two that were in the tree that were shaking their butts, trying to pounce down on you guys, they start hooting. And hissing angrily, but they're not like looking like they're gonna pounce anymore. They're like flapping their wings, just like posturing.
Is it my turn?
Yes.
Can I cast?
Wait, did someone ask something?
There's no more. Is there any more like in our vicinity?
Yeah, they're kind of all around the forest.
Okay, like, I'm gonna cast a healing word on
Okay, I'm only hearing, like, half
of
what's
going
on.
So,
1d4 plus... Hang on 1 second. What'd you say, Cassie?
Hearing, like, half of what's going on.
Okay.
I don't think anybody said anything when Metroid said yes. Like, I think he's just saying yes, they are all around, just as a clarification. I didn't hear anybody ask it.
Huh? Can you hear me?
Who can hear Katie?
I can.
Lor can.
Oh, I'm the one who asked it.
Oh.
I asked if there's any bad guys around us.
Oh.
I didn't hear it when you asked.
Oh, sorry.
All right.
Okay, so I'm casting Killing Word.
Okay. You can use your healing word to like stabilize him, I guess. That's pretty much, you can't like actually heal him, but you can like he's unconscious. I'm not sure how that works when you're at zero.
When you're at zero, like when it gets to his turn, he has to start rolling death saving throws. But if I heal him, he goes back to normal.
Okay.
Or not back to normal, but he goes back to whatever level I heal him to.
Okay, cool.
And at least 5th edition.
I forget 5th edition.
No, it's okay. So he gets 6 points back.
Cool.
He wakes up.
Welcome back to the land. As he wakes up.
and I get up and brush myself off. Thanks.
No problem.
So we're still totally surrounded?
Yeah, you guys are surrounded, but it looks like they're kind of sticking to the trees.
Are we getting out of here?
Yeah, I say we run.
Can we run?
Yes. You guys start making your way out of the forest, you guys see the landhawks, they start stalking you from the bushes, but they're not making any attacks. They're just, like, following you guys. They follow you guys right to the edge of the forest, but you guys make it back into the town.
Oof. Mm. I need a drink. But we should also get our money.
Then we can go buy some booze.
Yes, we can use the gold to buy the booze. Yes.
That sounds like fun.
We need to go talk to what is her name? Sebastian. We need to talk to her and get our money.
Yes.
Okay. So that's the plan? Going to the mayor's house?
Mm-hmm. Yes. Oh, neat.
Okay. when you guys go to the mayor's house, the constable's hanging outside. Oh, hey, what's up, guys? How fare thee on your travels? Any word of the woodpecker?
It's dead.
It's dead. Very
thanks
dead.
To this one.
Wait, what?
And I shove her forward.
Yeah, it's dead. That's all you need to know.
She lobotomized it, basically.
It's just dead.
It's very dead.
But like you drove it off?
No, we murdered it.
Like, it charged at us, and we killed it to defend ourselves.
No, I get what you're saying, but, like, it was a giant... No, there's, like, no way. There's no
you
way.
You can go find the body for yourself.
Do you hear?
And my dad wasn't doing that.
I told y'all we should have gotten a trophy, because these fools obviously do not believe us.
No, I've noticed I haven't heard anything, but I mean, I just thought you guys would make it go away, not, like, kill it.
We didn't know what we were going to do.
Yeah.
I mean, that seems like an oversight on your part, but that's just me. That's what I'm doing. But we did get rid of your problem, and we felt like that it'd be really good right now to discuss the matter of payments.
Yeah, okay. Lady Wynn's in her office. Just go right in there and talk to her. And the constable just kind of, like, walks away going, like, it's, like, they killed, like, dead. Like, he's, like, he can't even, like, think about it in his head. And you guys, can march into Lady Winifred's office, and you see her sitting at her desk, and she's signing papers, and looking very flustered and No, that won't do. Oh, what is he thinking? And she notices you guys and she looks up and she goes, yes, was there something you needed?
Your bird is dead.
The big one, not the smaller ones. The ones you're paying us to kill. Yeah, the one dead.
That's your claim?
You know,
do you hear any woodpecking?
I don't hear any pecking currently.
Then why don't you walk out there and look at the body yourself?
I mean, we can easily take you to the...
I'd rather not walk into the forest. I mean, these boots are very expensive. But I'll have the constable and the wood carver go look.
How long will that take?
I'm not sure. If you wanna, I can arrange to have the money prepared and set up in a fashion that's suitable for you and have it sent over to the inn. You could wait there.
Does that sound like a good plan? Yeah, I mean,
that sounds great.
You understand I need to prove that the bird is, in fact, gone.
Understandable.
Be careful of the, what are they called?
Landhawks.
Yes, yeah. We're well aware of the landhawk infestation.
They weren't very happy when the bird died.
I think they were buds, as Orange Peach would call them.
They're a bit of a nuisance. Every once in a while they drag a baby into the woods, but they're not that much of a pest.
Oh, as long as it's only one, yeah.
As long as they drop only babies into the woods, or, okay, you know what?
Well, besides the occasional livestock killing, they're not much of a nuisance.
As long as it's occasional, I suppose.
Anyway, I'll have the money sent over to you in the tavern.
All right.
Okay. So you guys move back into the tavern. And when you're there, you see that the barkeep is chatting up with the baker. You can tell she's the baker because she's covered in flour. The family is off in the corner eating their meals. The two twins are, you know, still being weird. The woodcarver is chatting it up with a female blacksmith. You can tell she's a blacksmith because she's covered in soot. And that's about it for right now.
Shall we head to the bar?
Get some. My floss is dry, so.
Okay, so how do you guys pass the time?
Is this the part where we drink and tell stories about ourselves?
Sounds good to me.
I guess.
And goes over to the barkeep because she wants to try to find where a library is. Like where the nearest library is.
How old do you have to be to drink?
There's no age restrictions.
Oh, good. Why are you laughing?
No, there's no reason.
I was just checking. I've never actually had anything besides like ceremonial wine or stuff like that. So, I don't know. It's very new.
It's all right. You can have as much meat as you want or couldn't pay for it. Yeah. Generally, that seems to be how it works for most people.
Okay. So you guys can order food and drinks and all that sort of stuff. As you guys are chatting it up and, you know, hanging out by the fireplace, Fallon bursts through the door and goes, "Oh, there you guys are. I got the potion to get rid of the, to drive off the woodpecker. Did you guys get the mercury?"
Oh.
Read me your notes.
You should probably address your note next time. We thought that was just for people that weren't us specifically. Yeah.
Well, didn't Poe tell you to read the note?
No, he said empty house.
He said that she's home.
He said cool. After I said it, it was really rad.
Yeah, it was not a very useful raven.
There wasn't really, yeah, read the note. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, hang on. I said tell them to read the note, and he said read the note, read the note. And I just thought he was going to say that to you guys, too. I think he's just repeating stuff. I'm sorry, guys.
Are you sure someone didn't paint your parrot black?
Well, crows are really smart. They can learn tons of different words.
Yeah.
Also magic.
I taught him to say nevermore. That was great.
Anyway, not that we don't appreciate your help. The thought is really nice, but we've already dispatched the woodpecker. Espel already dispatched the woodpecker.
Wow. Like, you guys kill it?
Via transorbital lobotomy, yes.
The whole bar goes totally silent. Like, and you notice that everybody's listening to you. And they go, she leans in again and she goes, "Wait, say that again?"
The woodpecker is dead with a dagger in its brain.
She threw a knife in its eye and it went all the way in there, just right in there. And it's done. Yeah.
We want that dagger back.
Huh. Impressive. Alright, well, I'll see you guys later. I guess I don't need this potion. And she just kind of storms off and does her own little thing. Everybody in the bar just cheers loudly and starts clapping you guys on the back and buying you drinks.
Oh, yay. My favorite.
The female blacksmith grabs one of you guys and hugs you guys really tight and gets soot all over you. So, basically, merriment all around, and you guys are very well taken care of for the rest of the day.
Esbel uses the moment to go talk to the barkeeper of us.
Okay.
She's asking where the nearest town with a library is. And she's still worried about that amulet.
Oh shit, we forgot about the amulet.
The barkeeper goes, well, I mean, you know, you gotta go to a city if you want to go to a library.
Which is where?
Hang on, let me see. Pulls out a map. The nearest city is... I'll just move everybody there. Boom. So, the nearest city is going to be Lake Town. So, yeah, you guys want to go to Lake Town.
Okay. Well, then that's my next goal.
You know, if you guys really want to go to Lake Town, sometimes there's a guy who comes by here every once in a while. Check out the billboard out in front of the inn. Sometimes he posts his schedule out there.
All right, thank you. And so, Esbel kind of taps Temerity on the back and says, "Remember that stupid amulet? You're helping me."
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I probably should. That's a...
You found the damn thing.
I mean, I was just awake at the right time.
And you woke me up in the middle of the night.
I mean, what were we supposed to do? Just sit there and let it possibly kill us? I was doing us a service, protecting the
team. You're doing this with me. I'm not doing this alone at this point.
Oh, God. Fine. Yeah, fine.
And then he looks at the other two and is like, "You're free to join us."
Huh?
Shall we go in there?
Did you not tell them?
I mean, what was I supposed to tell them while we were, like, walking, while Eleanor was giving us a lovely performance, while we were fighting the giant woodpecker and its little small land hawklings?
I'm confused.
There was a glowing amulet in the well. It was speaking, what was it again? I can't remember.
Abyssal.
Abyssal. It was speaking abyssal, and we should probably look into that.
Where is it now?
Still in the well, theoretically.
It should still be there, unless someone went and grabbed it.
Well, then probably still be there.
Should we
touch
things that we don't know what they are?
I mean, technically, neither of us touched it. It was in a bucket.
I think maybe Esvel touched it.
No, I don't think I did.
No, we made a note not to touch it with their human hand, with their hands.
Okay, cool.
Y'all are human too? Oh my god.
It is a figure of speech.
Oh.
Is this a short rest, or are we about to long rest?
Well, you guys leveled up. This is technically like a long rest, so you guys can spend that time.
What? We leveled up?
Oh yeah, you guys killed a giant woodpecker, so yeah, definitely. but that's for next time.
Yeah.
So everybody's level 2 now, and you guys get all your hit points and spells and everything back.
Do I do anything special?
Should be our character sheet.
Hmm?
Yeah.
Yeah, next time, just be level 2. That's pretty much how it goes.
That's it, okay.
Towards the end of the night, Lady Sebastian comes back into the tavern. She kind of like pushes the door open with her gloved hands, like, ugh, you know, doesn't like touching stuff. And, she folds her arms and looks down at the table where you guys are at. She goes, "I've confirmed it. The thing is dead. I'm glad. But, well, anyway, I wasn't expecting it. I'm...
Come again?
I wasn't expecting it to be dead. And I'm glad that it's dead. So here's your payment. And she whips her tail around, and her tail acting like a hand drops a little bag of coins onto the table. She says, it's all there. You can count it. 100 gold pieces.
Okay, so 25 gold pieces each. I don't know how much gold is.
Wait, it was 100 or 200?
100.
100.
25 each.
Yes. She's not stiffing us, right? Like, I don't know how economics works here, but this is like... Okay, yeah. 100 gold. Okay, cool. Got it.
From the poster, it doesn't specify how many people would be completing the task. So it sounds like it should be 100 gold crowns each.
Well, the poster never specified how many people would be showing up. It only specified how much gold would be given. Quote, you will be rewarded the sum of 100 gold crowns.
Yes, and I expect 100 gold crowns.
Well, then maybe you shouldn't have taken so many people with you into the forest.
But, miss...
I didn't choose, they also came.
It says you want it. You will be given the sum. That's me.
Yes, that's you. There it is.
I assume someone so prestigious as yourself will greatly appreciate the permanent elimination of such a threat.
It's obvious you come from something with a lot of cash. I mean, you're the mayor's, daughter in a farm town and you're wearing silk?
This village happens to fall under my father's lordship, yes. The Duke Sebastian is the lord over this village as well as many others. And I'm sure I could write to him and have you compensated, but it would take some time and I don't know how long you're going to be here. There's a cart coming by who makes normal stops to Lake Town. It would be nice if you were on it. If you're looking for work, that would be the place to go. I'm very busy.
I stand at this point and get very close to her.
Humor.
I mean, if you just don't want us to be here, you could just say that to our face.
My friend here, Bill, has been through a lot today. It'd be not a good thing for you to anger him in such a way. I mean, I personally feel that we've done the work. We did this, and you, who has a lot of money, who has done basically very little in this situation, should actually compensate us, and we'll be out of your hair in no time.
Let me write to my father and see what I can do. In the meantime, do whatever. Mm. And she kind of whips around and maybe knocks over a mug with her tail. Maybe it was on purpose. Maybe it wasn't. Who knows? But she leaves.
Thank you.
You're quite welcome. I like you.
Thank you. She likes me the most.
Mm. I mean, at least we have that going for us.
I don't know if you know this, guys, but people are usually pretty nice in this world, and we get along great.
And then we marry into the night? Is that what happens?
You guys can marry into the night. She did mention a billboard out front, and there's also the amulet.
Yeah, are we going to deal with that now?
Did we go and check to see if it's still on
the amulet? So I say we look at the billboard.
Okay. On the billboard, you notice a few things. Let me see. A few things catch your eye. Ba, ba, ba. I'll just do that. And I'll do...
that. Oh, my battery's pretty low on my computer.
I think we're almost done, so...
Okay, good, because I don't know where the charger is.
there we go. And one last one. Cassie, your note that you find is actually like in a little envelope that you see tucked into a brick in one of the buildings that only somebody who had your background would know to look for.
Okay.
It's like a geocache.
Peter.
Okay. So I go over to the note.
Yes. You should all have handouts in your journals or in your things.
Handouts. The yes. Bloodstain gun.
That's yours.
Okay.
You each find a notice or a note that is worthy of your attention. And I think that's where we're gonna leave it for tonight.
Okay.
Huzzah.
Good rep. Fine. I killed a woodpecker.
Yes.
You solo ulted the woodpecker and it worked out.
Ah, brother.